Hello students, we'll see the next topic under the process costing, under the cost accounting. We'll see the under the process costing, all the problems are over. We'll see the next topic, that is inter-process profits. We'll see the theory part and the one or two problems under this topic. Okay, first we'll see the inter-process profits, meaning when the output of one process is transferred to the next process at an inflated price, there is a profit. Okay, when the under the process costing, we are always transferring the output of process first process to the next process, right? Okay, for example, process A, B, C. Okay, output of the process A transferred to the process B, and output of process B transferring to the process C. Output of the previous process, the input for the next process, right? Right, but under the previous problem, see, output of the process, first process, for example, process A is the input. Okay, same, we are not altering it. For example, output of the process A is 10,000 rupees. So the input of process B is 10,000 rupees. We are not altering, we are not adding anything, right? Same as it is, but under the inter-process profit, when the output of one process is transferred to the next process at an inflated price is nothing but invoice price or cost plus it includes the profit also, there is a profit. For example, say output of process A is 10,000 rupees. Okay, at the time of transferring to the process B, we are adding 10% profit, means 10,000 into 10% means how much? 1,000 rupees. So now input for the process B is how much? 11,000 rupees. So at the time of transferring, we are adding the profit. So inflated price is nothing but cost plus price. Okay, this profit is called inter-process profit. That particular process profit is called 1,000 is the profit, right? Under the example, so inter-process profit. In other words, inter-process profit is the difference between the cost price and the inflated price of the output. It's nothing but difference. Inter-process profit is nothing but it's the profit between the cost and inflated or invoice price. Price of the output transferred from one process to the next process. Okay, it's nothing but under the previous problems, we are transferring directly to the at the cost price. Now, at the time of transferring from the one process to another process, we are adding some profit. That particular profit is called the inter-process profits. It's nothing but difference between the cost price and the invoice price or the inflated price. Okay. Inflated price is nothing but cost plus profit. Okay. Next, we'll see the what are the main objectives of inter-process profit. What are the main objectives to adding the profit to the cost at the time of transferring? See, to show whether the cost of production of each process competes with the market price. To show whether the cost of production of each if we transferring to the cost price means we are not going to get the whether they are that particular cost is ready to compete with the market price by adding some profit not as our wish, we are adding according to the market prices, right? According to the analysis of market prices, we are adding some profit. So by adding these profits to show whether the cost of production of each process competes with the market prices. Okay, next, to make each process stands on its own efficiency and economies. To make the each process stands on its own efficiency and economies. Okay, otherwise when we are adding the profit after finishing all the processes, we are adding the certain percentage of profit and we are deciding the selling price, right? But under by adding the profits under the each process means it stands on its efficiency and economies. We can see the efficiency and economies of a particular process. Next one, objectives to assist in making decision such as to buy a partly processed material rather than to process work internally, or to sell a partly processed product or to process it further. See,